put a load in the dishwasher. Take a closer look at my 1991 Celica GT4 Carlos Sainz, a rare car with only 150 Group A's being brought to Australia. First things first is the fantastic noises. Fantasies aside, I bought the car to fix up and compete in tarmac rallies and sprints. So let's watch a full leg of its first outing, freshly slapped together on a shoestring budget. Pretty cheaply, and we got it to, well, my mate picked it up, took it to his house in Queensland, and started work on it. He firstly jacked it up and got under it, and I wanted all the intercooler piping changed. He had a few toys of himself, of course, and I wanted the WC style exhaust, that sort of outlet there, those intake pipes and intercooler pipes changed. New exhaust, 3-inch all the way, without a cap, which was quite stupid. And put the suspension in it, which is BC coilovers, and looking pretty next to its red friend, which actually became mine later on. And started to look half decent with a before and after there. It was quite messy, and there you go, looks not too bad. We got it on the trailer and brought it down. We put the Oz Racing wheels on it, 17 inch and 17x8, and I've been waiting, 20 years to put those wheels on a Celica, and slapped them on with some Pirellis, and looked the business, that's for sure. And just had to wait till I could get it tuned, and I put the WRC carbon mirrors on it, and the Momo steering wheel, and adjusted all the suspension help from Jared. And just hung around till I got it tuned, and it really looked the business. For the money we spent, it looked quite good. And sort of putted around a little bit before we got it tuned, but then finally the day came and it had three boost levels, and it eventually got 210 horsepower on 17 psi, which was pretty good at the wheels, not too bad for a stock old 20 something year old engine. But then the clutch failed, we found out the hard way that it's engine out to fix. So that was a pain in the ass and a long wait, but finally we got to drive it. Little cheeky late night run there, and we took it straight to Eastern Creek for a drag meet, which was off the cuff. I'd never done anything like that, and we were surprised when it did a 13.2 at 167, which was unbelievable. What a car. I mean, probably cost me 10 grand at that point, and it was a little pocket rocket and such a good starting point for my build. And then I did the Twilight series at Eastern Creek, and it was just a blast. It handles so good, really taily, doesn't understeer much, but it feels heavy, so I can't wait to strip all the weight out and really reinforce everything, the chassis, get some proper suspension arms, and just do more tarmac sprints and rallies like this. It was just brilliant. And I eventually want to make it into a Repsol replica and have more cheesy grins like that.